Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College. I am happy to meet you again through this video lecture series on the subject heat and mass transfer. And today the lecture is 107 in the module conduction of heat transfer. And the topic for today's discussion is steady state heat transfer in a sphere. So we recap from the previous lectures. Earlier we discussed the general heat transfer equation in spherical coordinates. We derived the equation and we simplified the equation for different situation. Now we are going to discuss the one-dimensional steady state heat transfer in a sphere without heat generation. And at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to develop the equation for one-dimensional steady state heat transfer in a sphere without heat generation. And the student will be able to define the thermal resistance for the sphere. And the student will be able to solve problems on the composite spheres. So the one-dimensional steady state heat transfer in sphere without heat generation, the general heat conduction equation for the spherical system for a sphere, it is given here. So 1 by r square dou by dou r square dou t by dou r plus 1 by r square sine square theta dou square t by dou phi square plus 1 by r square sine theta dou by dou theta of sine theta dou t by dou theta plus q dot by k plus 1 by alpha dou t by dou t. That is the general heat transfer or heat conduction equation for spherical system. And we simplify the equation for the present situation. So here it is one dimensional steady state, one dimensional. So we consider the heat transfer only in the radial direction. So the heat transfer in the other two directions are dropped. So that is dou t by dou phi and dou t by dou theta, they are dropped. And it is a steady state heat transfer. So we delete the temperature variation with respect to time. Dou t by dou t becomes zero and there is no heat generation. So q dot is zero. So finally, it is what the equation for the present situation. One dimensional steady state heat transfer in sphere without heat generation. The governing equation is 1 by r square dou by dou r into r square dou t by dou r equal to zero. Now we have to solve this equation to find the heat transfer in the sphere. And we take a sphere here, a hollow sphere of inner radius r1, outer radius r2. The inner surface temperature is T2, T1 and the outer surface temperature is T2. So for this governing equation, the boundary conditions are T equal to T1 at r equal to r1 and T equal to T2 at r equal to r2. So this equation, the governing equation, is to be solved within the boundary conditions and we will find out the heat transfer and the temperature distribution for the one-dimensional sphere. So integrate the equation. So we have 1 by r square dou by dou r square dou t by dou r equal to 0. You take r square to the right side, this becomes dou by dou r square into dou t by dou r equal to 0. Integrating first time, it is r square dou t by dou r equal to c1 and rearranging dou t by dou r equal to c1 by r square, integrating again t equal to minus c1 by r plus c2. So this is the temperature distribution equation. And here we have two constants, c1 and c2. To find the two constants, we will be using the boundary conditions. And using the first boundary condition, T1 equal to C1 by R1 plus C2 and T2 equal to C1 by R2 plus C2, and you find the T1 minus T2, that will give, when you find T1 minus T2, C2 is getting cancelled, minus C1 by R1 plus C1 by R2 is equal to C1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2 minus 1 by R1. So from here, C1 equal to T1 minus T2 divided by 1 by R2 minus 1 by R1. So this is the constant C1 and you substitute in the first equation. So T1 equal to minus 1 by R1 into T1 minus T2 divided by 1 by R2 minus 1 by R1 plus C2. So from here C2 equal to T1 plus 1 by R1 T1 plus T1 minus T2 divided by 1 by R2 minus 1 by R1. So we have the C1 value here and C2 value here, and using the C1 C2 value we will find the temperature distribution. So the temperature distribution T equal to 1 minus C1 by R plus C2, substituting for C1, minus 1 by R into T1 minus T2 divided by 1 by R2 minus 1 by R1 plus C2 equal to T1 plus 1 by R1 into T1 minus T2 divided by 1 by R2 minus 1 by R1. Now we rearrange. So I take the T1 to the left side, it becomes minus T1. I take T1 minus T2 to the left side, it becomes T1 minus T2. So T minus T1 divided by T1 minus T2 equal to, in the first term, so simplifying the equation, denominator is common. So denominator is 1 by R2 minus 1 by R1. So what is left out? 1 by R1 minus 1 by R. So finally, the temperature distribution T minus T1 divided by T1 minus T2 equal to 1 by R1 minus 1 by R divided by 1 by R2 minus 1 by R1. What is the significance of this equation? So R1, R2 are the known radius, inner radius and the outer radius. T1 and T2 are the known temperature, inner and the outer surface temperatures. And the unknown value is T for any given value of the radius between R1 and R2, we can find out the temperature here. That is what the temperature distribution equation. And rate of heat transfer. So we calculate Q equal to minus Ka dT by dR at R equal to R2. So heat is transferred to, we assume heat is transferred towards the outer surface. So at R equal to R2. So Q equal to minus K into A equal to 4 pi R2 square, and dT by dR equal to at R2 equal to C1 by R2 square. So substituting for C1, minus K into 4 pi R2 square into 1 by R2 square multiplying by C1, T1 minus T2 divided by 1 by R2 minus 1 by R1. So this R2 square is cancelled, minus 4 pi K into T1 minus T2 divided by 1 by R2 minus 1 by R1. And to drop the negative sign, I change the direction of the denominator. So Q equal to, finally, we take the 4 pi K to the denominator. So T1 minus T2 divided by 1 by 4 pi K into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. So this is the heat transfer. So T1 is the inner surface temperature, T2 is the outer surface temperature, K is the thermal conductivity of the material, and R1 is the inner radius, and R2 is the outer radius. And the heat transfer Q from the previous discussion, the heat transfer Q equal to T1 minus T2 divided by 1 by 4 pi K into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. This is the hollow sphere. R1 is the inner radius, R2 is the outer radius, T1 is the surface temperature, T2 is the surface temperature at the outlet. And this is what the corresponding circuit. So T1 is the temperature of the inner surface, T2 is the temperature of the outer surface, and for the heat flow, R is the resistance, which is given by 1 by 4 pi K into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. So thermal resistance for the sphere, this is equal to 1 by 4 pi K into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. And the concept of thermal resistance is very much useful to solve problem on the composite sphere, as in the case of what we did earlier for the slab and the cylinder. And if you look at the composite sphere, I have two layers, spherical layer, first layer and the outer layer of radius R1, R2, R3 and temperature T1, T2, T3. And this is what the corresponding thermal circuit. So T1, T2, T3, R1 is the resistance offered by the first layer of the sphere. R2 is the resistance offered by the second layer of the sphere. The value of the resistance are 1 by 4 pi K1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2, or R2 equal to 1 by 4 pi K2 multiplied by 1 by R2 minus 1 by R3. The rate of heat transfer equal to T1 minus T3 divided by R1 plus R2, and interface temperature we can calculate using this equation. So Q equal to T1 minus T2 divided by R1, which is also equal to T2 minus T3 divided by R2. So the resistance T1, actually first resistance T1 minus T2 divided by the corresponding resistance. For the second resistance, T2 minus T3 divided by the corresponding resistance. So from here, we can calculate the interface temperature. And we solve the problem. We solve one problem and try to understand the concept. A sphere of outside diameter 10 cm is maintained at the uniform temperature of 225 degrees Celsius, is exposed to the ambient at 25 degrees Celsius with the H value, heat transfer coefficient 50 watts per meter square Kelvin. Calculate the thickness of the insulation of thermal conductivity 0.08 watts per meter Kelvin required to reduce the heat loss by 17%. And the write down the given data. Outer radius of the sphere is 0.05 meter, surface temperature is 225 degrees Celsius, ambient temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, heat transfer coefficient is 50 watts per meter square Kelvin, and thermal conductivity of the insulating material is 0.08 watts per meter Kelvin, and the reduction in the heat loss is 17%. Now, heat loss from the sphere without insulation. So, this is HA into delta T. So, 4 pi r square into h into T1 minus T infinity, substituting the numerical values, 4 pi into r equal to 0.05 square into 50 into 225 minus 25, that is equal to 315 watts. Then we calculate heat loss from the sphere with the insulation, it is only 17%. So, Q dash equal to 0.17 into Q, this is equal to 0.17 into 314 equal to 53.38 watts. So, heat loss from the sphere with the insulation is 53.38 watts. And the thermal resistance with the insulation, R equal to delta T by Q, which is 225 minus 25 divided by 53.38, which is 3.75. Now, the total resistance, R equal to 1 by 4 pi K into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. Plus 1 by 4 pi R2 square plus H. So, this is the resistance due to the new addition of insulating layer and this is the resistance due to the convective heat transfer. So, substituting numerical values 3.75 equal to 1 by 4 pi into 0.08 into 1 by 0.05 minus 1 by R2. The outer radius of insulation is the unknown plus 1 by 4 pi R2 square into 50. So, solving, simplifying mathematically. So you will get a numerical equation, you will get a quadratic equation. So look at the final step, 16.15 R2 square minus 0.995 into R2 plus 1.59 10 power minus 3 equal to 0. So this quadratic equation is to be solved to find the value of R2. And solving the quadratic equation, R2 equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. So, using the equation 0.995 plus or minus square root of 0.995 square minus 4 into 16.15 into 1.5 10 power minus 3 divided by 2 into 16.15, simplifying 0.995 plus or minus 0.942 divided by 32.3. So, the R2 value is 0.06 meter. Now, the thickness of the insulation required, T equal to R2 minus R1, which is 0.01 meter, which is 1 centimeter. So, the answer to the problem, thickness of the insulation required is T equal to 1 centimeter. And we take another example, a hollow aluminium sphere with the electrical heater in the center is used in test to determine thermal conductivity of the insulating material. The inner and the outer radii of the sphere are 0.15 meter and 0.18 meter. The inner surface temperature is 250 degrees Celsius. In a particular test, the spherical shell of insulation is cast on the outer surface of the sphere of thickness 0.12 meter. The system is in a room of air temperature 20 degrees Celsius with the H value equal to 30 watts per meter square Kelvin. If 80 watts of heat is dissipated by the heater, what is the thermal conductivity of the insulation? So, I have a hollow aluminium sphere with the inner layer, a heater inside and we have an insulation. First layer is the hollow aluminium sphere, the second layer is the insulation and we have outside air at a temperature 20 degrees Celsius and the heat transfer coefficient 30 watts per meter square Kelvin. And this is the corresponding thermal resistance. So R1 is the resistance due to the hollow aluminium sphere, R2 is the resistance due to the insulating material, and RO is the resistance due to the convection on the outside surface. So if the given data are R1 equal to 0.15 meter, R2 equal to 0.18 meter, R3 equal to 0.3 meter, T1 equal to 250 degrees Celsius, the amount of heat dissipation is 80 watts. So the resistance due to the aluminium sphere is 1 by 4 pi k into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. Substitute the numerical value is 1 by 4 pi into 204.2 into 1 by 0.15 minus 1 by 0.18 equal to 4.33 into 10 power minus 4 Kelvin by watts. And the resistance due to the convection R infinity equal to 1 by 4 pi R3 square into H equal to 1 by 4 pi 0.3 square into 30, which is 0.0295. The total resistance for the heat transfer. So Q R equal to R1 plus R2 plus R infinity, which is T1 minus T infinity divided by Q, which is 250 minus 20 divided by 80 equal to 2.875. And resistance due to the insulation, so R2 equal to R minus R1 minus R infinity, substituting the numerical values, so the R2 value equal to 2.845. And R2 value equal to 1 by 4 pi K2 into 1 by R2 minus 1 by R3, which is 1 by 4 pi into K2 into 1 by 0.18 minus 1 by 0.3, which is equal to 2.3845 Kelvin by watt. And solving this equation, the thermal conductivity of the insulating material, K2 equal to 1 by 4 pi R2 into 1 by R2 minus 1 by R3, which is equal to 0.062 watts per meter Kelvin. So the thermal conductivity of the insulation is 0.062 watts per meter Kelvin. This is the answer for the problem. And these are the reference books I used for the preparation. You can also reach to those books for our further knowledge or for many more problem on the theoretical concept. And this is the book what I have published earlier in this subject. You can refer to it for additional problems. And if you have any doubt on this topic of discussion today, you can write to my mail ID. I will answer to all your queries. Thank you very much. We'll meet again.